thank you very much for the introduction. It's a pleasure to see so many of you here, and I hope that my discussion today of the various body parts and viscera of assorted saints isn't going to make some of you regret an early lunch, or put some of you off a lunch after this. So anyway, as I'm sure all of you will know, the 950th anniversary of the Battle of Hastings was commemorated at the weekend. Fought on Saturday, the 14th of October, 1066, it's arguably the most decisive battle ever to take place on English soil. And I think this image of last weekend's reenactment at battle shows that the event still resonates with people today. The ruins of the monastery founded by William on the site of his great victory are a tangible reminder of these events, the events in 1066, that is, not last weekend. For 500 years, the monks of Battle Abbey remembered their founder and all those who fought and died there in 1066, singing for the everlasting salvation of their souls. And the subject of my talk today is overlooked evidence of the religious life of the community at Battle. It's an inventory or a list of saints' relics compiled at the monastery in the middle of the 15th century. It's one of only about 30 or so such inventories to survive from an English medieval religious house. But unlike the others, the Battle inventory has received only very, very limited comment, and it's never previously been transcribed, let alone published. While transcribing the inventory and identifying the 140 or so relics it lists has been a fascinating and, dare I say it, enjoyable experience. And at the very least, it's greatly enhanced my understanding of the medieval cult of saints and their relics. But work on the inventory has been much more than an antiquarian pursuit, and standing at this podium, how can I say that there's absolutely nothing wrong with that? The inventory is an incredibly valuable source for the study of Battle Abbey. As I'll explain, it's possible to determine how the Abbey obtained at least some of the relics in the inventory, evidence of Battle's enduring relationship with the conqueror and his successors well into the 13th century. It provides some gleanings about the art and architecture of the monastery, riches destroyed at the Reformation. And most importantly of all, it significantly adds to our understanding of the spiritual life of the monastery, most obviously the cult of saints' relics there, but also the religious identity of the community at Battle, the Abbey's liturgy, pilgrimage to and from the monastery, and Battle's relationship with the wider English, indeed European, church. These are all subjects of great scholarly interest. Indeed, I hope to eventually publish my research on the inventory in an appropriately learned journal. But I also think they have the potential to enhance the visitor experience and understanding of Battle. And the religious life of the monastery will be a major theme in a new museum opening on the site in the spring of next year. And I do hope my talk here today acts as a stimulus for you to visit. Now, the inventory is now in the Huntingdon Library in San Marino, California, where so many of the Abbey's manuscripts are now cared for. Since the Middle Ages, it's been bound with six other works, all of a historical nature. Indeed, it was common for relics lists to be placed with historical works, as they helped very much construct the self-identity of religious communities. The inventory covers four pages or two folios, and the Battle provenance is explicit. At the top, you've got an ex libris inscription, and this shows that the inventory entered the Abbey's library in the mid-15th century, recording as it does. It was a book of the Monastery of Battle donated by Abbot John Newton. Now, he was elected in 1463, dying in 1490. The inscription is accompanied by the press mark IN, which you can see there. And this is found in other surviving manuscripts from the monastery, which were likewise donated by Newton. The inventory opens in translation with, "These are the names of the saints whose relics are contained here at Battle." Before his election to the abbacy, Newton served as the monastery cellarer, and it appears that the inventory was actually compiled somewhat earlier by a predecessor, That was Thomas Bird, who occupied the office between 1436 and 38, and his signature is very faint there at the end. The inventory is in Latin, and it's written in a neat black-letter Gothic bookhand. Each page, as you can see, has two columns, and each is ruled with 26 lines. There are two large decorative initials at the beginning, you can see there. And you can see also, I hope, that there's further rulings down each of the columns, so the addition of other catch letters. But these were never added. The inventory follows, at least in the first two-thirds, a standard hierarchical arrangement found in almost all medieval saints' relics inventories. It starts with the relics of Christ, followed by those of the Virgin, the Archangel Michael, John the Baptist, the Apostles, the Martyrs, the Confessors, and the Virgins. However, the convention breaks down around about here, and after that, the arrangement becomes much less, and the arrangement becomes much, much less predictable. The final 46 or so relics, approximately a third of the total, don't follow any discernible order, and the significance of that I'll get to later. And we have quite an array and variety of relics. They include the relics of Christ, as I've said, of his life on earth and of his passion, portions of the cross on which he was crucified, the true cross, part of his tomb, the Holy Sepulchre, the marble table where he dined with his mother and disciples, and the wood of his manger. There are portions of the clothing of the Virgin and various other saints. We have the hair and beards of some saints, including Peter and Paul. And there are also assorted body parts, the finger of St. Lawrence, the 3rd century Roman martyr, the arm of St. Wilfram, who was Archbishop of Seine in northern France in the 7th century, the jaw and 13 teeth of St. Brigid, Abbess of Kildare, who died in 525. I could go on. And we have the dust of the flesh of various saints as well. Adding to this are various bits of holy ground. They include fragments of the rock into which the cross was fixed on Calvary, the ground upon which Christ, the Virgin, St. Michael, John the Baptist, and some other saints stood. And there are a large number of relics which just begin with de, meaning of. That's to say, a non-specific relic or even a contact relic. It was believed that some of the sanctity associated with relics could be transferred by mere touch. And indeed, I am wearing such a contact relic. In 2004, there was a trip from the Courtauld to Aachen, where there was a major exhibition. And it coincided with a major pilgrimage to Aachen Cathedral, which has an incredible array of relics. So in a piece of experimental archaeology, I took off my wedding ring and I was handed to an attendant who touched it to the reliquary containing the swaddling clothes of Christ. So there we are, a contact relic of the swaddling clothes of Christ. Now, many of the relics I'm going to discuss were found in other medieval English lists, but there are some especially rare or interesting relics, which I'll get to presently. But first of all, what are relics? Well, they provided, and to many still do, physical, tangible reminders of Christ and his saints. For the Catholic faithful, they were and are an aid to salvation, believed to offer protection or even to be endowed with magical powers. And the cult of relics goes right back to early Christian times. This was a time of periodic persecution for the church. Followers of Christ did give their lives for their faith. And by the late 2nd century, the remains of these martyrs were being collected, preserved, and venerated. Polycarp, Bishop of Smyrna, died for his faith in around 160. You can see him depicted here in this wonderful mosaic in Ravenna, dating to the 6th century. Eusebius, the 4th century church historian, records that Polycarp's companions took up his bones, which were more valuable than precious stones and finer than refined gold, and laid them in a suitable place. In the following centuries, the cult of relics gained in importance. From the late 8th century,